Now, before removing the belt, the Volvo will just remove the crank pulley, but actually we can do without removing the pulley. So the whole idea is just to go underneath here. You notice there's this bolt, it's a 10, and there's another bolt. Just remove these two bolts, and you will remove the small plastic cover that sits there, and we are going to pass the belt through that place without removing the crank pulley. Careful with these 10 mm bolts, they are very easy to round and they are actually pretty stuck in there, and I think they have Loctite on them, so it really slips easily on the wrench, especially the wrenches has multi-points. With the cover removed, we'll need to remove the old belt. Some people cut it, but you'll have to pass the new belt anyway through this space. Basically, if you pass your hand, the belt is there. There are a couple of, the pulley comes close to a couple of things. It's either the block, either some covers. So just pass your hand first and you will notice there's a bump. It's passing very close to the pulley. You'll have to pass the belt through there. Then at the top as well. And if you go around, there's also the bottom, a very tight space. You need to pass the belt there. And there's also cover here at the almost rear top. So basically the new belt and the old belt eventually, they will need to pass through all these small tiny passages. For the old belt, it's just a matter of fiddling because the belt is stiff, and you will have probably, maybe it's better to just cut it off right away. But the new belt, what's the important thing is not to twist the belt. So as you see, the belt is long. Do not twist it. Well, you have to twist it very slightly, but do not force on it. That will break the fibers inside the new belt. So go very gently and take your time really to pass it very nicely and gently without twisting it too much, without crushing, bending it too much. That it's pretty important actually for the life of the belt. Now the belt, it's hanging, is not attached to the pulleys or anything, the new belt. So first you need to pass the bump in front bottom here. So place the belt vertical, basically just touching the surface of the crank pulley. Pass the first bump that's in there, then pass it like this. Underneath, just like that. So first bump is done, and then for the second one there is a corner of a plastic cover here which is very annoying. Keep the belt vertical like this and bring it forward towards the pulley, crank pulley. Do not push it back away from the pulley. Then eventually it will move place. That's the corner of the plastic which is really annoying. So you really need, it's really very tiny between the plastic and the pulley, otherwise it won't pass it. And that's all. Now to put it on the upper pulleys. So just to double check, make sure the belt is seated. Insert it nicely over the teeth and the water pump as well. It's seated inside the teeth. Perfect. This is just a better view of the notches on the crank. Notice the camera is not exactly on top, so it's not straight above. It's just slightly sideways. So this is the notch on the engine side. It's very tiny bump here, right there. And then when you look on the teeth on the pulley, there is tiny tiny notch there, and there's a tiny tiny notch there. So this bump must sit in between those two teeth.